Hello, 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 and welcome to today's episode of Her Version. This podcast is dedicated to sharing stories of struggle and triumph, a platform that allows individuals to tell their truth in order to inspire and uplift others. For those of you that are new to this podcast and like content like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button, follow, like, and share. I am your host, Sabrina Victoria. Let's jump right in. Thank you for joining us today for this episode of Her Version. The Her Version platform is built on storytelling and the understanding that many times our greatest learning experiences come from listening to other people's stories. Today, I am speaking with an amazing woman named Dr. Marisol. I'm going to let her pronounce her last name. Marisol is no stranger to toxic relationships, and many of us have had in our home, our work environments, and our romantic lives. It is no surprise that she is now a teacher in the arena of leadership. She is here to share her story and talk about the importance of mindset and standing confidently in your skin. Welcome, lady. How are you?
Thank you so much. I'm doing so great. Thank you for having me here.
Yes, so tell us where you're from first.
Okay, so I'm from the Dominican Republic. I live in Miami, so I'm here in the United States, but I'm Dominican and also, you know, American, so I'm Dominican-American. I was born in the DR, and I was there. I grew up there, and then I came to Miami when I was 16.
Very
interesting story.
I love it. And then how do we pronounce your name correctly?
So correctly is Capejan.
Capejan.
Capejan. So you will pronounce it like if the two L's were a J.
Capejan. Oh, Capejan. Okay.
Yes. So I had to teach my husband how to pronounce it because he's American. And I'm like, how do I teach him? And I was like, think of a J.
I love it.
That's what it is. Yes.
I love it. Well, I'm so excited to have you here and for you to be able to share some of your story, some of your journey, some of what you're doing now. I know that you're working on so many things. You actually caught my attention. I reached out to you cold because of an awesome article that I read that you had written about women being pet to threat. Brilliant.
Oh, yes.
Absolutely brilliant. I read it. I was like, I have to have this woman on my podcast. I reached out to you cold. You're the sweetest, most gracious woman.
Oh,
I appreciated you giving me some of your time and some of your thoughts on like what's going on within, you know, culture, within females, and where you are at now. Mm-hmm. And I know you were kind of like jiving. You were kind of like doing some research and doing some stuff. So I'm really excited to kind of see where you are now because it's been a second.
It's been a second. So yes, I wrote that article because in my LinkedIn account, I have a woman in leadership newsletter, right? And what I usually do is I try to read and research and ask and interview people about women in society, women in the workplace specifically, right? Yeah. So when I did my doctoral degree, my doctorate's degree is in education, and my dissertation was about the trajectory of to leadership positions, the woman's trajectory to leadership position. So how do women start their career and then rise up to, you know, an executive level position? And it's very interesting because women have very unique challenges. Yeah. When I was doing my interviews and I was doing the literature review, I read things related to gender bias, the motherhood penalty, other, you know, terms that have been coined by other researchers that you have to, like, you know, read about them and make sure that you really know what you're writing about. Yeah. So I'm reading through all of these things. And one of the things that I saw that caught my attention was the term pet to threat. And that basically shows that Black women specifically have the unique challenges in the workplace. Scientist did a study, and she basically found that, you know, women, Black women specifically, they're treated as a pet at the beginning sometimes in the workplace, meaning they are, you know, treated in a childlike manner sometimes, where, you know, they're being taken care of kind of in the public, or the company portrays that they're taking care of them. But then as the Black woman starts rising up or gaining confidence, all of a sudden she becomes a threat. Mm-hmm. And even the people that used to promote the woman, or Black women specifically, they start, you know, turning their backs on Black women. And they face a lot of challenges from the same people that helped them at the beginning. So it was a very interesting study. So I started reading about that and reading about experiences. I went through some experiences like that too. And I just thought, you know, we have to raise awareness about the unique challenges that we face.
Yeah.
Women, Black women, Latinas, Afro-Latinas, they also suffer, like, go through unique challenges. That's not saying that, you know, that everything is negative in the workplace. It's just that if we want to create an equitable workforce where people feel that they belong, mm-hmm. where they feel like they matter, that their opinions are being heard, we should take into consideration what really happens in the workplace and what experiences do minorities actually have, so that we can make changes and make sure that we are fostering a climate that is inclusive.
Absolutely, definitely.